Nazir, working in Nagrami PCX.
Working as a colorist over here. I started my career by 2003 at Taj Western here at Race Course Road, and I moved to Maldives. I was working there for 4-5 years, then back to India. Now I'm working at Academy of Pastry Arts, Pastry and Culinary Arts, Bangalore.
Yeah. Good evening, guys. Welcome to Academy of Pastry and Culinary Arts. I'm Chef Jagdish with you all. As this is my colleague Chef Charles, as he introduced you. So now, today we'll be demonstrating a couple of things with you, which is couscous with ratatouille. So these are the ingredients which we are going to use for the demo today. So basically for couscous, we'll be using, this is called instant couscous, which is made out of durum broken wheat. Okay, it can be prepared instantly by adding hot water. And then we'll be making ratatouille, which is a French classical dish. Again, basically it's a stew. So we'll be using all of this raw materials. Like, we'll be using some chopped garlic, some chopped onion, and we'll be using some zucchini, bell peppers, some yellow squash and tomato. Also, we'll be using some fried aubergine. Alright. Is it audible for all of you? Is there any difficulty in understanding? Please let us know via your comments. It's fine? Great. So we shall start. So initially, first we'll start with cooking the process of couscous. Okay? So Chef Charles will be showing you the demo of cooking couscous. So basically you need some hot water. Okay? And we'll be adding some butter. Okay, you can add some herbs to it to give more flavor. So let's get started.
Yeah, to start cooking with the couscous, the ratio of couscous and water is 1:1. So if you take 250 grams of couscous or 200 grams of couscous, 200 ml of or 200 grams of water. And we need piping hot water. So initially first, heating it up. Meanwhile, a little about couscous. So this will tell you.
So couscous is basically made out of durum broken wheat. Okay, it is also known as a tiny pasta, which can be which can be used as pasta. It can be used in various way. It's a staple food of Moroccan. Okay, also it is widely used in North Africa.
So to the water, we add some butter to it. Little bit of salt.
So the best combination of while making couscous, I would prefer sage. Sage is a kind of herb which gives you very aromatic flavor. Okay, so again, due to COVID, we are short of sage. But again, there is an alteration. We can also use thyme, which is again very aromatic.
Couscous is actually a very simple way of cooking. It's called as instant couscous. So instant, just need some hot water. So once in the hot water, it will start cooking, and by maximum by 2-3 minutes, it will be ready. Yeah, see the water is boiling now. Don't let the water to boil so much. Just add a couscous to it. Make sure the water goes into it. Yeah. It's done. Yeah. So we want the hot steams inside so that it cooks properly.
It's very easy to cook couscous. There's another way which you can do it very simple. Like at home you can use couscous in one ceramic bowl. You can just add water, butter to it, and then you just microwave it for about 1 minute. That's more than enough. That's another simple way to make or cook couscous. So now the water is, the couscous is been added for hot water. It will take another 2-3 minutes so that it becomes soft and spongy. Okay. Meanwhile, we'll learn how to make ratatouille. Ratatouille is, again, as I told you, it's a French classical stew. Okay. So we'll be using all these ingredients for making ratatouille. All right. So let's get started with making the couscous of ratatouille. So initially we are using light olive oil, about 2 or 3 tablespoons. So once you feel the oil is hot enough, okay, we'll add chopped garlic. So the key is here, we are not supposed to burn garlic, okay? You are just supposed to sweat the garlic. Means you just need to get the flavors of garlic, okay? So we are not going to burn the garlic, we are just going to sweat the garlic. So once the garlic is sweat, we are going to add our onions. So now at this point of time, the garlic flavor is good enough, okay? It is just sweated and it is just cooked. Okay, now we'll add our chopped onions. Again, in chopped onions, we are not supposed to burn them, okay? We just need to sweat the onions until it turns translucent. So there's, if you need to cook onions a bit faster, simple tip where you can add some salt to it while cooking onions, it will fasten the process of cooking onions.
Chef, the Bombay chef is saying we would love to hear from Chef Charles as well.
He is under monitoring. So once your onions are translucent, we can go for other raw materials, like we can add pimentos. So we have green capsicum, we have yellow and red bell peppers, okay. So we don't want our pimentos to be completely soggy. So when it is during this cooking process itself, we are going to add some of tomato paste, a tablespoon of tomato paste, or it depends upon the quantity what you are making.
So we have to cook the tomato paste completely. So the tomato paste gives us rawness. So we have to cook it until the rawness goes off. And when you are doing it in a dry heat, it will cook more faster and also give more flavor.
So ratatouille basically will have my tanginess in the stew along with crunching your squash and your zucchini. Thank you. So once the raw flavor of the tomato paste is goes away from the pan, you can go for other vegetables, like you can add your green chili and your yellow squash. So after adding tomato paste, the key is here, you are not supposed to cook them in very high flame, because it has a tendency of getting burnt at the bottom. So make sure that you keep mixing the vegetables at a regular interval.
So Jagdish Sabha says hi. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Waiting for biryani.
One more time, sir.
Sabha waiting for biryani.
So as we told you earlier, we don't want our vegetables to be very soggy. So at this point of time, we can add our tomato fungus or de-seeded tomatoes.
Chef, we have two people asking what we are cooking today. So can you please give a brief intro again of what we are doing?
Small recap
or just
so
tell them.
We are making couscous along with ratatouille. Okay, couscous is a Moroccan staple food, and ratatouille is a French classical stew. So we are expecting chunky tomatoes. I mean, it is not supposed to be very soggy again. So at this point of time, we are going to finish the ratatouille with fried aubergine. So we can season it with salt and white pepper powder. If you want it to be slightly spicy, you can go for a black pepper powder.
So chef, we have a question. Can we use quinoa instead of couscous?
So we are making Moroccan couscous. Quinoa is possible, but it is not couscous.
We can make quinoa, the cooking time differs. Quinoa is not so fast cooking like couscous. It takes more time.
Okay,
and
we have
the ratio of water is also different.
We have another question. Why did we de-seed the tomatoes?
Why we de-seed the tomatoes?
See, basically we use tomato fungus, okay? De-seeding tomatoes, I mean, we need chunky tomatoes. Okay, we are not going to make it as a stew.
And moreover, the tomato flesh, I mean the seeds along with the thing, it has more tanginess. So to cut that, most of the country cooking or any Western cooking or any Arabic cooking, if you see, they use tomato fungus or de-seeded tomatoes.
So the final stage of our ratatouille, we are going to finish it with some oregano. The classical way. So it is always suggested to add your herbs at the last or during the finishing stage. Okay. So there we have thyme too. Okay, thyme also gives a wonderful flavor for ratatouille. So we'll be finishing the ratatouille with some oregano and thyme at the last.
So chef, we have two questions. One is by Sabha asking, can we add corn to this? And
yeah.
Corn.
Classically, no.
And then we have another person, Janvi Mamtora, asking, have you just fried the eggplant or have
yes.
you added some spices to it as well?
Nothing. It's just fried.
Okay.
Done?
So that's it. Our ratatouille is done. Now we'll see how the how does our couscous look like. So it's been almost about 2 to 5 minutes now. So it's perfectly cooked. This is how your couscous looks. It is nice and spongy. You can add whatever flavor you want. It can be used as pasta too. Okay, we'll finish this couscous by adding a bit of extra virgin olive oil. So we'll finish our couscous by adding some extra virgin olive oil.
Chef Roshan is saying hi to you, so he wants you to say hi to him back.
Roshan?
Yeah.
Hi.
Chef, say hi, he's waiting.
Hi, hi, hi.
Chef, we have a question. How to cook couscous?
You can watch the video later. Okay, we'll do a simple presentation of couscous and the tea together. We can use some tomatoes and English cucumber, which is called as Japanese cucumber. We have got some Kalamata olives, which you can add some Kalamata olives. Okay. Along with this, now you can top our couscous with ratatouille. If you have basil, you can go for basil while cooking the ratatouille. If not, you can also garnish it with some beautiful parsley, curly parsley. So, I hope you enjoyed the process of making ratatouille and couscous. It's a very simple way of presenting the couscous and ratatouille. Anybody can do at home. Alright? It again depends upon the herbs what you get in the market. If you get sage, that is the best. While cooking your couscous, you can add some shredded sage. It gives wonderful flavor to it.
Soon we'll be adding Miss Parul, nutritionist. Okay, if you have any nutrition kind of questions to her, she'll be able to answer you.
The nutrition value of this food is also quite good.
Hi everyone.
Hi,
Mira. Hi, how are you? It looks good. Beautiful.
Thank you so much. Hope you enjoy
the lockdown. Oh yeah, really. And I was really thinking that is such a good option for vegans. People are opting for veganism, and this is such a easy and nutritious option.
Yeah, actually yes. And some question is there, like, where is this dish's origin from? Yeah, it is origin. Ratatouille, if you see, it's from France, from the Nice, the region, and couscous is from Morocco, and mostly it is used in North Africa also nowadays. Yeah. So going into the nutrition values, yeah, please go ahead.
So, if you compare it can be compared to our semolina, suji. So, it is basically made from durum wheat,
yes.
Couscous, and correspond to suji. So, I mean, not exactly the same, but nutritionally, yes, almost the same. Okay. Also, one thing I just observed. Obviously, while cooking couscous, you used a lot of butter. So, as a nutritionist, you know, you're like, oh my God, so much of butter going in. But I guess one can substitute it with the olive oil instead of the butter, just in case you are a hardcore vegan.
I should get the sugar. Yeah. You can substitute it with olive oil, but generally, olive oil is always drizzled on top for the flavor and the essence. Butter
yeah, so some other.
To make sure it doesn't stick together.
Right. So, any other oil that you can suggest?
It's a very wrong concept of, many people use olive oil for cooking. So, olive oil is never used for cooking at all. It is always drizzled on top. Only then you can bring in the aroma of olive oil.
Yeah, so there's a reason why we don't cook olive oil.
You're right.
Because it is unstable in high heat. That is why we don't cook. We just drizzle it on the top.
Once the olive oil is, once it reacts with heat, it's no more olive oil. It loses all of its flavor, and it's just a fat.
So basically,
kind of fat.
Yeah. So, the nutritional part of it that you basically lose on the mufas, which olive oil is very high on, and that is why that's the reason we don't heat it much.
Great. So, any questions, guys, for Ms. Parul?
Some question is there.
I guess Anjana said that this is broken wheat, which is dalia. Yeah, but it is refined. It has a low amount of fiber as compared to dalia, our Indian dalia.
Right.
And moreover, it is cooked. It is cooked and it is instant. We can cook it instant. So like normal broken wheat, we have to cook it for a long time. This is already pre-cooked and it is dehydrated and we get it in an instant form. So you put just hot water, it will get ready. That's it. Anything else?
I was just thinking, is this dish okay for diabetics?
Yeah.
I would say no, but during the video, one of the viewers said that can we use quinoa? So if you substitute couscous with quinoa or dalia, then it is fine for diabetics.
Okay. But I guess couscous has lots of fiber in it.
Not that much. Not that much. Yeah, not much. Yeah, and someone is saying that what is couscous in Hindi? I don't think it has a Hindi name. Some things are just out of India, so overcome things. So we don't have it. In fact, when I was doing my dietetics, quinoa and couscous didn't exist because in India we've got it now after so many years. Are there any questions that we have skipped?
Any questions? So far, no other questions.
You can also give some nutrition values about using tomatoes.
So there's another interesting question.
Yeah.
There's another interesting question which says that, would you say that it is a balanced meal? So I would not say it's a balanced meal because it is not... high on protein. It is very low on protein. So I would not say that it is a very balanced meal. But you know, if you are having it, you should have it for lunch, according to me, since we'll be having it with couscous. So I would say it's a very beautiful meal to have for lunch. Dinner can be more high on protein, so that's my suggestion. Someone asked about vitamins, and so obviously because this is full of vegetables, I could see every color of vegetable in it, raw or cooked. I would say that this meal, this dish is full of vitamins and minerals. In fact, awesome for Corona, because you are building up on your immunity. So you can, I mean, this is a very good thing.
Vitamin B16 is there. Vitamin B16 or B something. I just read that. B6? Vitamin. It's high.
Yeah. So generally high on fiber and vitamins and minerals. So when we classify vegetables, we are classifying something, the vegetable is source of vitamin and mineral in our diet. And it is just that. It was all the vegetables I could think of.
Any other questions, guys? No more questions.
So, guys, feel free to ask if any other questions, if it comes to your mind, okay? At ABCA page, okay? We can also answer you back on ABCA page itself. All right. I hope everyone is safe at home. Okay.
Be safe.
We all of us are praying that Corona gets over very fast. So be
and
safe.
Be back in business.
Yeah. Have sun. Have a lot of fun by cooking at home. I hope half of the world is having fun with only cooking at home now. So
there's
cooking.
Another question, Chef. The person asks that what is the dietary source of folic acid? So lots of fruits and vegetables would be the best source of folic acid.
Amazing. Yeah.
Right. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you. See you soon with another recipe.
Thank you, guys. See you soon.